I think that, yes, if you get a sore neck or a headache or a pain somewhere where you don't expect to get it, you think, oops, is this something? But I try not to think that way, because I think it is better to just go on hoping and being positive.
When I have my scans, is it going to be in my bones? Is it going to be in my brain, liver, lungs? So those thoughts are still with me now, nearly 2 years on, but not every second of every day.
I really tried to put it out of my mind, and I succeeded, except for every time I'd go and have a checkup. And then I would go through the agonies of really, really thinking, oh my God, you know, is it back? Is there something else? And you make your funeral arrangements and you do all kinds of things that are irrational. You know, you have all sorts of dark thoughts about what's going to happen and what you've got to go through. So you are irrational.
As far as I'm concerned, it's all gone, and it's not coming back. And if by some miracle it did come back, which it's not going to, that it'd be a whole different disease.
Now that I'm moving towards the end of medical treatment, yes, I'm thinking, there's always that question in the back of my mind.
The hardest thing is when you don't have any more contact with doctors, that's when you get heightened panic and that feeling of absolute pooping yourself that no one's going to look after you anymore. And I still have that now. I mean, 13 years down the track, every now and then it will enter my mind, but I just have to get it checked or turn my mind thoughts around and think it's okay, or talk to a friend. I think if, again, I have that support where I've got someone I can talk to, that when I am feeling a bit anxious, I've got someone who just calms me down a bit.
But the fear of recurrence is never far from the front of my mind, and I actually went to see a psycho-oncologist to try and put some strategies in place to deal with that. Some relaxation strategies, it helped a bit, I guess. I just nowadays have a stern talking to myself and say, oh, come on, Kim, you know, if it's going to come back, it's just going to come back, and don't let it ruin the rest of your life. And I guess as time goes on, I think probably less about it. It's the edges soften a little bit.
A little bit in the back of my mind, but I try and stick to this figure, which I hope will be true, that I'm 95% cured, and that it should never come back again. So, but there is that 5 or 7% of chance that, yeah, things will happen and it might come back. But I try not to think about it.
And I don't need to be, you know, walking around every day thinking, wow, there's an X percentage chance of this coming back for me.
I exercise. I talk with friends. Some people write. I'm not really one to write, but probably more for me verbally. Opening up about it. On the coast there's an amazing cancer centre, Bloom Hill. I go and talk to counsellors there, and when I initially did that I thought counselling is just for people who are a bit nutty, but after I did it I think everyone should go and do it. That made me feel a lot better and more secure.
Just having an independent third person to talk to about it, and to, you know, express those fears of, you know, I'm really scared that it might come back, or I'm scared I might die, or whatever, you know, because it's difficult to talk to your family and your friends about those things because they just have a freak out, which is completely understandable.
The best solution is always to have your mind occupied with something else, and my mind was very occupied with all sorts of things.
I think every day's a bonus, and I don't tend to think about those things. Of course, there's a little niggle, but really in the scheme of life, what the heck? If it comes back, it comes back.
In the lead up to appointments, or if I'm feeling a bit stressed, I go for a walk down the beach and there's a bench seat. And I sit on that bench seat, and that seat was dedicated to a woman who passed away over 20 years ago. And in my head, I talk to that woman. And I just say, hi there, hope you're having a good day and this is what's happening. Don't say that loud, but by the time I've done a brisk walk on the beach and just sat with her, because I'm sure she's there on the chair somewhere, I just find that helps clear my mind a little bit. And as nutty as that probably sounds, it works for me. So, and are you sitting there today listening?